and gentlemen, let me introduce and welcome to the stage President Walt Cuneau. Walt?
Welcome to the Americana World Community Center today for the Downtown Rotary Club's Louisville's annual Mayor's State of the City Address. Please find your seat as Barbara has been shepherding us all along, and we will start here in just a second. I'm Walt Cuneau, president of the club, a Paul Harris Fellow. Welcome you to the February 2nd meeting of our Rotary Club, and to give us our invocation is Kevin Fields. And Kevin is the president of the Louisville Central Community Center, a club director, and chair of our Diversity, Equity, and Inclusion Committee. Welcome, Kevin.
Thank you, President Walt. And good afternoon to everybody. To President Walt, fellow Rotarians, our mayor, and to our guests, it is indeed an honor to invoke God's blessing upon us today. As we have embarked upon a new era, 2023 years after the crucifixion of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, and in the first year of our city's new mayor, Mr. Craig Greenberg, we gather once again to share and learn in fellowship and in truth as brothers and sisters, all committed to the common cause of advancing health, safety, and prosperity for every citizen of our great city of Louisville, Kentucky. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we come to you seeking your guidance, your wisdom, and your Holy Spirit as we convene today's meeting of the Rotary Club of Louisville. Father, we ask that you allow us to grow closer as community partners, to build alliances necessary to achieve your will, and to produce sustainable solutions to the problems we face as a community. Help us, Father, to engage in meaningful dialogue that is based on truth, fairness, goodwill, and friendships, all such that we take away from this meeting ideas and initiatives that can be beneficial to our entire community. And Father, we ask a special blessing upon our mayor, his wife, his family, and his entire administration as he leads us toward being closer to what you would have for us to be. We pray for our mayor's health and safety and for the continued success of his administration. We ask these blessings in your name, our God in heaven. Amen.
Thank you, Kevin. And to give our pledge and our four-way test is Deputy Mayor and Rotary Vice President Barbara Sexton Smith.
Thank you, President Walt. If everyone would please stand and join me as we say the Pledge of Allegiance together and the Rotary four-way test. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, and liberty and justice for all. And now for the four-way test, as we Rotarians say in everything we feel, think, say, and do. Is it the truth? Is it fair to all concerned? Will it build goodwill and better friendships? Will it be beneficial to all concerned?
Thank you, and you all be seated, please. Now, please welcome the Kentucky Opera, Sankara, Harouna, to sing our national anthem accompanied by David Mamedov on the piano. Thank you so much, Barbara Lynn Jameson, for arranging this for them to perform for us today. Barbara Lynn's down here. Thank you.
Stripes and bright stars.
Wow, what a way to kick off this glorious day. It is Rotary's honor to host this Mayor's State of the City. Our club is one of the oldest and largest of 46,000 clubs around the world, which was chartered in 1912, over 100 years ago. We hold weekly meetings where together we say the Pledge of Allegiance, pray an invocation, and repeat our four-way test of we think, say, and do that you just heard about. We have 350 extraordinary members who are people of action and live out our motto of service above self, working together to promote peace, to fight disease, to provide clean water, to support education, to care for our planet, and much more. We welcome business, civic, and faith leaders who hold positions of significant influence in their organization or community and reflect the rich diversity of leadership in our city. Our club participates in many local initiatives that I'd like to highlight now for just a second. We are working to make Louisville a better place to live, from our lending a hand to a neighbor with repair affair, to serving dinner at our Recenter Ministries. Rotarians are there. When the tornadoes hit western Kentucky and when the floods plagued eastern Kentucky, Rotary was there. Within days of the humanitarian crisis in Ukraine, Rotary was there with $20 million in relief. In addition, our local club sent over 300 pounds of winter clothing to our sister club in Kyiv. Rotary is there. Rotary decided to take the scourge of polio and tackle it in 1987. And today, we are this close to eradicating that plague from the face of the planet. For our 100th anniversary in our Louisville club, Rotary decided to have a promised scholarship for our scholars at Western and Iroquois high schools, which included life skills coaching to these young people. We raised $2 million in endowment that supports $80,000 of scholarships every year, and our coaching has impacted over 750 students with 3,000 hours of community service. Rotary is there. During our civic unrest, your Rotary Club stepped up and stepped in with short-term support for dental and medical clinics in West Louisville. Our biggest project to date is our West Louisville Housing Initiative, where Rotary is raising $5 million for first-time homeowners in our 9 named neighborhoods that cannot qualify for a conventional home loan. This one-of-a-kind program where Park Community Credit Union is the fiduciary. These dollars go to first-time homeowners who may have two jobs. She may be a single mom living with her children in less than desirable situation. She has the income, but not the credit score to secure a loan. We step in, help her get her loan, support her through the home ownership process, and as she pays it off, that money is returned to the loan pool for the next one. We feel like we'll be able to help almost 70 first-time homeowners, and as they improve their credit rating, they can qualify for a conventional loan and then replenish that loan pool again. We'll have more money over the next years as this program gets underway. Traditionally, generational wealth comes through home ownership, and Rotary is helping start the process. Rotary is there and will always be here in Louisville making our community better. Rotary's also looking for doers. This could be you. For more information about membership, there are flyers on the table, or you can visit LouisvilleRotary.org. Our mayor, Mayor Craig Greenberg, was elected the 51st mayor of Louisville last November, and he was sworn in on January 2nd. He comes to public service as a successful career in business as the former CEO of 21C Museum Hotels. He served on the University of Louisville Board of Trustees, among other civic and community roles. He and his wife, Rachel, are the proud parents of two sons, Daniel and Benjamin. Please welcome our 51st mayor, Craig Greenberg.
Thank you all so much. As you guys know,
I'm big into moving the city in a new direction and doing things in a new way. So I had this great plan to sing my State of the City address. But after Sankara's rendition of the national anthem, I think I might just stick to speaking. That was amazing. That was amazing. Good afternoon, everyone. Today, I'm going to share some of what I've learned in my first month as your mayor and where I believe we are headed together. And the one thing I've learned is that we have an incredible team of dedicated public servants who love our city, who work hard every day for the people of Louisville. I'm honored to be their colleague, and I want to introduce you to a few of these hardworking folks who are here with us today. When I call your name, please stand. First, Lieutenant George Manley works in the canine unit with our Department of Corrections. Sandy Chesser is a supervisor with Metro 911 Dispatch. Major Stephanie Way is an operations officer from Metro EMS. Tim Civils helps take care of our beautiful Metro parks. Ahmed Farah is a program coordinator with the Iroquois branch of Louisville Free Public Library. And finally, Director Lidge Edgehill with Family Health Centers, who works right here at Americana World Community Center. Before we recognize them, I also want to ask my partners who were on the Metro Council who are here with us today to please stand. And to our deputy mayors, directors, and the other folks who are part of my new administration, let's have a big round of applause for everyone who is part of our city government, the 5,000 public servants who work hard every day for our city. Thank you all so much. Thank you so much to each of you. Thanks to Walt and everyone with Rotary Club for hosting this amazing annual event. This includes two Rotarians from my administration, one, Deputy Mayor Barbara Sexton Smith, who you just heard from, and also Deputy Mayor Nicole George. And I appreciate the opportunity to talk about the state of our city in a vibrant and dynamic neighborhood right here in South Louisville. So a very special thank you to Emily Dyer and the entire team here at Americana World Community Center for hosting all of us today in this great facility. And a special shout out to my good friend Edgardo Mancia for his many years of service to Louisville right here at Americana. This center is a very special gathering place. It's a place where parents and children who came here from other countries and other traditions came to learn English together. This gym that we're in has hosted celebrations for Haitian Flag Day, the Karine New Year, Somali Independence Day. I first visited Americana over 20 years ago with my amazing wife, Rachel, who's here with us today. Back then, she was a wonderful English as a second language teacher at Wheatley Elementary School in the California neighborhood. And we came here some weekends or after school to help her students that were here getting other enrichment, educational, athletic, extracurricular activities. And we saw them and the power of the programs here as they and their families got accustomed to a new life in a new country. Students from Beachmont to Burundi, Serbia, Somalia, and all over the world were studying and learning here at Americana. Many of Rachel's students back then, and a lot of the people who come to Americana still today, are refugees who've seen war, violence, and persecution. They've come here from all over the earth, and this center is their common ground. And when I visit here, I think about my own maternal grandparents. They were born a century ago in Germany. My grandmother left soon after Hitler came to power. My grandfather escaped in 1938, just a few days before Nazis rounded up 30,000 Jewish men and sent them to concentration camps. One of our most treasured family heirlooms is my grandfather's original passport that we still have today. It has the symbol of the Third Reich of the German officials who stamped it when he was fortunate enough to leave his country. That stamp, which you can see on the screen here, marked the beginning of the journey that took my family to America and eventually led my parents to Louisville, where I grew up and now have the honor of serving as your mayor. Thinking about my grandfather and about the people who come to Americana, I'm struck by what an incredibly courageous and hopeful decision they made to leave the place they knew and move across the world to an unknown place where an unknown future awaits them. To make that journey requires hope, determination, resilience, and the ability to adapt to changing circumstances. That's what they had to do to overcome tremendous challenges and create a life for themselves and their children. That's an inspiring lesson for me as I think about where we are as a city and where we want to be. Today, I'm proud to say that the state of our city is strong. Our people are strong. And while we are facing challenges, we're also connected by our love for the city all of us here today call home. And together, we're ready to move in a new direction, toward a future that's big enough and promising enough for all of us to thrive. My team and I have a plan to do just that, to work together with people across our city, people who are already engaged in trying to make Louisville a safer, stronger, and healthier city. And let me be fully transparent. Since we're only a whopping 1 month in, some elements of our plan are still taking shape. So today, I'll share some announcements with you. There'll be many more in the coming weeks ahead, and I'll provide even a more robust agenda when I present my budget proposal to the Metro Council in April. Overall, I'm so excited about Louisville's future, for a lot of reasons, one of which is the strength of our overall economy. Ford, UPS, and other businesses, large and small, have announced major expansions. Downtown is coming back in a big way. That's right. Derby City Gaming will open downtown soon. So will Hotel Genevieve. In fact, we are building multiple hotels to accommodate the visitors we know are coming. Louisville Tourism expects us to have more visitors in Louisville in 2023 than we did before the pandemic in 2019. The New York Times just named Louisville one of the top 52 global destinations, praising our parks, our vibrant LGBT community, and our, quote, bourbon-fueled convivial spirit. That's right. To attract visitors and improve quality of life for Louisvillians, we're expanding Waterfront Park all the way west to 14th Street, which will connect downtown. It'll connect downtown with Portland, Russell, and West Louisville. And while we're talking about West Louisville, we have great momentum to build on. I can't wait to cut the ribbon on the Goodwill Industries and Norton Healthcare Opportunity Campus, including the first hospital built west of 9th Street in over 150 years. And there's much more to come. Within Metro government itself, things are very exciting. Things are exciting with the Louisville Free Public Libraries. I'm looking forward to building on the work of previous administration and the Metro Council support and being the mayor who reopens the Parkland Library, closed since 1986, and the new and expanded Fern Creek Library. That one's been closed since 2019. And with the help of our partners at the Library Foundation, we're going to expand and transform the Portland Library and our flagship main library downtown. These are just a few of the reasons we have to be excited about our city's potential. and we should be, as we look to the future and work towards our goal of making Louisville a safer, stronger, and healthier city. And to take on that goal, we need to look squarely at our challenges as well. And we are. Like with public safety, that's the first and greatest responsibility of metro government. In fact, of any government. And I want to give a special shout out to another exemplary public servant who's here with us today, Chief Jacqueline Gwynn Billaroel. She assumed command as interim chief of LMPD on the same day I did a month ago, and she's doing an outstanding job leading this department. Chief, thank you very much. Please stand and let us recognize you. Our dedicated police officers and other community members are working hard to reduce violent crime in our city. But we can and we must do more. We lost 160 neighbors to homicide last year. That's far too many. One homicide, one act of violence is far too many. Because we know that behind each one of those numbers is a human being, often a child, a friend, a relative, someone who our kids went to school with. And each of these crimes is a tragedy for the person on the receiving end of the violence and for the person committing that act of violence. These tragedies hurt their families, their communities. They hurt all of us. To make our city safer, we have to continue implementing reforms and make LMPD the best police department in America. That means we support our officers with the training, recruitment, resources, compensation, and leadership they need to do this incredibly difficult and important work. This means improving transparency, collaboration, and accountability. And we have to prevent more crimes from happening in the first place. To continue making our city safer, we need to find more resources, programs like group violence intervention, and for education, training, and employment programs like Evolve 502, Code Louisville, and an expanded summer works. We have to expand the hours of programming in our city's community centers, libraries, and parks. We're developing both short and long-term solutions. Our goal is to help people who might be on the path to tragedy find reasons to change direction. The good news is that there are nonprofits and foundations that collectively have hundreds of billions of dollars available to help cities and community organizations. And that brings me to my first announcement. Today, I'm incredibly excited to announce the creation of the first Mayor's Office of Philanthropy. We'll work in partnership with local and national foundations and nonprofits to coordinate strategies and investments geared towards solving some of our city's biggest challenges. And I'm also excited to introduce the very first executive director of the Office of Philanthropy. She's most recently served as the Vice President for University Advancement at the University of Louisville. Please join me in welcoming Mariana Barzin. Mariana, please stand. Thank you so much for joining Metro Government. Mariana's leadership of our Office of Philanthropy will help make our city safer, stronger, and healthier. And early childhood education is essential to making that happen. That's why I've asked Mariana, as her very first project in the Office of Philanthropy, to develop a plan to make universal pre-K a reality for all 3- and 4-year-old children in Louisville. I'd like to thank Governor Andy Beshear for his strong support of universal pre-K across the state. And I'm also encouraged by the conversations I've had with our delegation from Jefferson County in the General Assembly and other leaders of both the Kentucky State House of Representatives and Senate, encouraging them to pass universal pre-K legislation and address other critical needs for our city and our state. In fact, just yesterday, I was in Frankfurt meeting with the Republican Jefferson County delegation to the General Assembly, and the day before that, met with our Democratic delegation. Because I think it's important for all of us to cultivate a strong, open, and honest partnership with our state leaders in Frankfurt, because we need each other. And developing a partnership based on shared interest and mutual respect is the only way we'll improve education and make other needed changes in our state and our city. And we already have great examples of successful partnerships between the state, local, and federal government. In fact, just yesterday, we announced that Louisville will be investing nearly $27 million to make improvements to some of our most dangerous roadways. Through the bipartisan infrastructure law, we're receiving most of that funding from the federal government, with some from the state government, so we can refigure some of our roadways to make them safer. Like sections of West Oak Street, River Road, Berry Boulevard, 22nd Street, Southern Parkway, and more. These changes will save lives and prevent injuries and help families walk, bike, and drive more safely through the neighborhoods of our city. I want to thank all of our state and federal partners for making this possible. This is how we work together to serve the people who we all serve together. This is the approach we need to take on other challenges, like reforming our broken juvenile justice system, so we don't lose any more kids to either gangs or crime, or lose them to a system that simply doesn't help them. And we have to work together to find a way to reduce the number of illegal guns on our street and the tragedies those guns make all too possible. It's only through partnership, absolutely. It's only through partnership and cooperation that we'll be able to build on the economic progress we're seeing in Kentucky right now. We need an economy that does more than just create jobs. We need one that provides careers and the promise that hard work today will lead to greater reward for you and your family tomorrow. Too many people in Louisville today and throughout our history have heard that promise, but haven't seen it or lived it nearly often enough, particularly in our Black community. That's why it's essential that we work with urgency to counter the impacts of generations of disinvestment and systemic racism. That's the goal of the equity work that Metro government and community partners are dedicated to advancing in every aspect of life in Louisville. To accelerate that progress, I believe that the mayor's office needs a designated leader who can help coordinate efforts throughout all of Metro government and all of our city. That's why I'm proud to announce today that I'm elevating the Office of Equity into the mayor's office itself. And I'm proud to introduce the new executive director of the Office of Equity, Joy McAtee. Joy, please stand. The work of this office will take many different forms because we need to factor the need for racial justice and equity into every decision we make at Metro government. Not during this month, which is Black History Month, but every month, every day. And I urge every organization in our city, every business, house of worship, nonprofit organization, school, to do the same. And being here at Americana reminds us that achieving equity demands recognizing that different communities have different needs. Take our immigrant community, for example, which is the fastest growing part of our population. They make a tremendous contribution to our economy and the cultural life of our city. Despite dealing with legal and language hurdles, the rest of us never have to consider as we do our jobs and raise our families. Years ago, Metro government created an office for globalization. But it's time to refocus that office and that work to better serve and strengthen our growing immigrant community, because that strengthens our community as a whole. And that's why I'm proud to announce that as part of our Office of Equity will be the newly named Office of Immigrant Affairs. And I'm proud to introduce the person who will be leading that office, Amos Izeramanam. Amos, please stand. Thank you. Thank you, Amos. As I've said, we are working to make Louisville safer, stronger, and healthier. And to become a healthier city, we have to adopt a new vision for what it means to be healthy. Improving our health means more than reducing physical illness. It means continuing to tackle the evils of addiction and to do more to support people's mental and emotional health. And becoming a healthier city also means that we address the fact that we have too little affordable housing and too many people living on our streets. That's why I made several game-changing announcements last week. First, Metro government is investing more than $8 million to help people right now who are in danger of being evicted from their homes. This will keep some people from becoming homeless in the first place and is a partnership with the Louisville Urban League, the Association of Community Administries, and the Legal Aid Society. Also, Metro government and community partners will build a first-of-its-kind community care campus to address our homeless crisis. The community care campus will provide temporary housing, food, laundry, and wraparound services like medical treatment and mental health care, employment help, and more to people who are experiencing homelessness or who are in imminent danger of losing their housing. The community care campus is another great example of partnership, this time between Metro Government, Norton Healthcare, the Coalition for the Homeless, and U of L Health. And speaking of U of L Health and our great University of Louisville, I want to introduce you all here today to our brand new University of Louisville president, Kim Schatzel. Kim, please stand. Welcome to Louisville. We are all so excited to work with you, with our friends at JCTC, Bellarmine, Spalding, Simmons College, and that amazing university down the road, the University of Kentucky. We're also joined today by President Eli Capiluto from Lexington. President Capiluto, please stand. Thank you so much for joining us. It's through partnerships between UK, U of L, and other amazing educational institutions that we can work together to educate our kids for a brighter tomorrow. Thank you all so much. Back to affordable housing. To help address the fundamental need of affordable housing in our city, the final part of our game-changing announcement last week is that Metro government is investing $24 million to build more permanent affordable housing in Louisville. And thank you to the Rotary Club for stepping up as a partner in this initiative. Thank you for creating the West Louisville Housing Initiative to fight the legacy of redlining. Metro government is committing $1 million to help fund the West Louisville Housing Initiative, and I encourage other businesses, people, and organizations to support this initiative as well. Solving our housing crisis is critical because everybody deserves a safe, affordable, and quality home. And when we make it easier for people to find homes and stay in their homes, we improve the quality of life for everyone. This work strengthens our economy and helps make sure that our public spaces, our streets, sidewalks and parks are safe, clean, and accessible to all of us. And speaking of parks, we will address the chronic underfunding that has left our wonderful metro parks in need of improvements and attention. And that's why I'm so grateful for the support of partners like the Olmsted Parks Conservancy, Wilderness Louisville, and the Parks Alliance of Louisville, which spearheaded the Parks for All action plan we unveiled last week. Parks for All is a comprehensive long-term roadmap we'll use to build equity and excellence in each of our 120 parks.
along with our community centers, pools, golf courses, greenways, and more. Our thanks to the Parks Alliance of Louisville for helping us sustain and improve the parks that the people of our city love so much. And talking about the importance of our parks and our green space underscores the fact that we need to make Louisville a national leader in urban sustainability and health. We have a huge advantage in this work already. Thanks to the work of our partners at the 100% Renewable Energy Alliance of Louisville, the Louisville Sustainability Council, and University of Louisville's Christina Lee Brown Environ Institute. They are a great partner in helping us build a healthier city by reducing carbon emissions, embracing green technology, and striving for cleaner air, water, and soil. Metro government needs to be a stronger partner to organizations like these, along with many others. That's why I'm announcing also today that we are elevating our Office of Sustainability. It too will now be part of the mayor's office itself. And I'm proud to introduce our new executive director of the Office for Sustainability, Sumedha Rao. Sumedha, please stand. Sumedha's job is to help us find solutions to our sustainability challenges, to factor sustainability into all the decisions we make at Metro Government, and to make our city a healthier city. Mariana, Joy, Amos, and Sumedha are among the amazing group of people who've brought their skills and passion for our city to work for Metro Government. We are looking for more people with a similar passion for public service to join our team. So if you or someone you know is thinking about public service, here's what I can tell you. I've been a full-time public service for a whopping 1 month now. It's incredibly stimulating, challenging, and important work. And there's a sense of purpose and satisfaction when you go to work every day because you're working for your neighbors, for your community, for the city you call home. And as you can tell today, you get to work with some amazing people every day. So if that sounds good to you, please join us. Just go to louisvilleky.gov and click on the Find a Job link at the bottom of the page. We'd love to have you join our team. Because the truth is, I'm excited about where we are and what's ahead. I'm excited to continue working with and learning from people from all over Louisville in partnership, together. My team and I will be traveling throughout the city to better understand and meet the needs of our neighbors in the east, in the west, in the south, inside the Waterson, and outside the Waterson. We want to hear from everyone. And we want people in every part of our city to understand that every Louisville neighborhood is a vital part of our city. And whether we grew up here or came from somewhere else, we're here because we love this place and we believe in it and we're ready to move our city in a new direction. And yes, there is a lot we don't know about the future. What we do know is that we'll face it together. And I know that if my grandparents could face the challenges that were once in front of them, and the folks who come here to Americana could face the challenges that were once in front of them, then we can absolutely face the challenges that are now in front of us. Let's face them with hope, determination, resilience, and excitement about the future we can create. Today, the state of our city is strong. Tomorrow, let's work together to make it even stronger for ourselves, for our children, for our entire city. Thank you all very much.
Wasn't that fun? Wasn't that exciting? So we've got a couple of presents the Rotary Club does. Mayor Greenberg may or may not know, but he will now, that he is an honorary member of our club. And to signify that, let me pull something out of my hat here. We have a, there we go. So you can come to our Rotary workouts, perfect. Anything that you need for Rotary.
I will, I'll be wearing this as I run this weekend.
Perfect, perfect.
Thank you.
And on a more serious note, you talked about the West Louisville Housing Initiative, and we do this with all of our speakers. We have, Rotary has made a $500 contribution to our West Louisville Housing Fund in your honor. Oh, so thank you for doing that. Thank you so much. I'm not much on saying good luck, but saying best wishes, because our future is in your hands. Thank you, and I'm so glad.
Thank you so much. Take care. Thank you all.
I would now like to invite Sankara and David back to the stage to perform another song for us before we adjourn. I don't know, but I'd ask you to come up here and do it again. So as we reach the end of our meeting, Also, I have Walt's words of wisdom. They're not on the screen today, but particularly when Sankara sang the song, I went to one of them. Impossible is just a big word thrown around by small men who find it easier to live in a world they've been given than to explore the power they have to change it. Impossible is not a fact, it's an opinion. Impossible is not a declaration, it's a dare. Impossible is potential. Impossible is temporary. Impossible is nothing. And that was said by our own hometown hero, Muhammad Ali, and Mayor Greenberg. Impossible is nothing. Thank you all. We are adjourned.